In this video, we're looking at a one-dimensional kinematics problem where two objects are moving and interacting. So I have car number one located at x equals 0, car number two located at x equals 200 meters, and when the clock starts, both cars begin accelerating toward each other with differing accelerations. A1 is 3 meters per second squared, A2 is 5.5 meters per second squared in magnitude, but it points to the left, so I put a minus sign on it. In part A, I want to get the time at which these cars run into each other. So the key to these problems is to get a position versus time function written down for each of these cars. And that comes from our basic kinematics formula, x equals x naught plus v naught t plus 1/2 at squared. That's describing the position of an object as a function of time. So I write down my position function for car number one, and that's given by the initial position, which is 0, plus the initial velocity times time, which is a 0 times t, plus a 1/2 times the acceleration times the square of the time. And those first two terms are gone, and that 3/2 simplifies to 1.5. And now I can describe the position of car number one for all moments in time. It's just 1.5 times t squared. We do the same thing for car number two, but the initial position of car two is 200. The initial velocity is 0 because it started from rest. And then my acceleration has a minus sign in it, so I'm going to pull that out in front. I get negative 1/2 times 5.5 times t squared. And this gives me a 200 minus half of 5.5, which is 2.75 times t squared. So now we have two position functions that describe the position of each of these cars for all moments in time. Now we have to do a little bit of physical reasoning. What does it mean for the cars to crash in terms of the mathematics here? It means the positions are the same. So x1 is equal to x2. Then I can plug in the position functions for each of these cars. x1 as a function of time is 1.5 t squared. x2 is 200 minus 2.75 t squared. I add the quadratic term to both sides, and this gives me 4.25 t squared. Is equal to 200. And finally, we divide by 4.25 and square root the result. And this gives me a time of 6.86 seconds. Okay, now that I know what time it is when the cars crash, I'm asked in part B to find the position at which they crash. So where are they relative to the origin, which I put at the front of car one? And you have two choices of how to do this, and it's actually best to do it both ways as a check on your work. I can find the position of car one evaluated at t equals 6.86 seconds. So I just plug into my position as a function of time, which was 1.5 times the time squared for that car. And when I run the numbers on this, I get 70.6 meters. So the crash happens, let's say right about here, about 70.6 meters. Closer to the starting position of car one because it wasn't accelerating as fast. And so technically we're done with the problem, but I always go back and check the position of the other object to make sure it agrees. So what's the position of car two when we plug in 6.86 seconds? That's 200 minus 2.75 times 6.86 squared. And this agrees with my first answer, giving me 70.6 meters. Now I'm very confident I have the right answer. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.